In this video, we will start to define our second quantity that we use in our thermodynamics chapter, and that is the quantity of entropy. So as we mentioned in the intro video, in order to determine whether a reaction is going to be spontaneous, we need to know both the enthalpy and the entropy of a given reaction. And so here we are defining entropy. The main definition of entropy is that it is a measure of disorder. So entropy itself, we use the capital letter S to represent that. And the units of entropy are measured in joules per mole per Kelvin. So two key things to note. One is that we use joules instead of kilojoules. So the value of energy for entropy is much less than we see for enthalpy. And the other interesting note in here is that temperature is a factor. And hopefully that makes sense. If we're measuring the amount of disorder of a substance, as temperature increases, remember we have more kinetic energy for a given substance. The more kinetic energy there is, the more entropy there is. So as temperature goes up, the entropy of a substance will go up. Other ways to think about entropy or other words you can use to describe it. Is how spread out atoms or molecules are, or dispersed, how chaotic they are. The more movement they have, the more entropy there is. You can also think of it in terms of randomness. So again, all of these words can help you try to predict entropy of different substances. As we proceed through this section on entropy, we will define that we can not only measure the pure entropy value of a substance, but we can also measure the change in entropy for a given reaction. Again, remember, change is going to be final minus initial. And so as we discuss chemical reactions or processes, we would look at the products minus the reactants. So as we look at the change in entropy of reactions or processes, we don't have a specific term to describe the change in entropy. For example, for enthalpy, we can describe a reaction as endo or exothermic. For changes in entropy, we don't have a simple term like that. For these, we just describe whether disorder is increasing or decreasing. For a given process where the change in entropy is positive, we describe that process as seeing an increase in disorder. This should make sense. If we have a positive value, it means the products have more entropy than our reactants. And so as this system proceeded, as the reaction happened, there was an increase in disorder. For a given system where we calculate or predict a negative value for the change, we describe this as a decrease in disorder. For this one, as we subtract products minus reactants, we see that here reactants actually have more disorder. And so as this reaction proceeded, there's a decrease in disorder or an increase in order. Either one of these phrases can be used to describe the process. So looking at a couple of examples, here we look at the change in physical states of a substance. Hopefully it makes sense that as a substance goes from a very ordered solid to the little bit of chaos we see in the liquids to the very, very chaotic system of a gas, our entropy is increasing. So as we go from solid to liquid to gas, entropy tends to increase. Other factors that affect the entropy of a substance are relative sizes. So here we're comparing a molecule of F2, only two atoms, to a molecule of ozone with three atoms. Recognize all of the different types of motion we have here. For the diatomic fluorine, the only change that happens is the stretching and relaxing of the single bond we have between the fluorine atoms. Versus ozone, because we have two bonds in here, we can have multiple variations of options for how this molecule can be arranged. So notice the vast number of arrangements here of those three atoms versus just the two. So in general, when we're comparing sizes of atoms in the same physical state, again, only changing one variable at a time, the more atoms in a molecule, the greater the entropy. So at this point in class, what I typically have students do is pair up or work in your groups and determine for each pair of substances for the criteria listed, which one do you expect to have more entropy? So I will ask you to pause the video here, take a minute, and predict which one in each pair you predict to have more entropy. When we come back, I will review the answers. All right, now that you've made your guess, we will go through and discuss each one of these. And so again, when I ask you to compare entropies, I'm only going to change one variable at a time. In our first one, notice the only difference here is our change in state. So as we discussed, gases will always have more entropy of a given substance. Gases will have more entropy than liquids or solids. For our second example, the variable that we're changing is the number of atoms in a molecule. And as we just described, the more atoms we have, the more bonds there are, the more variations in how that molecule can be structured and how it moves. The same idea with our third example. For iron to nitrate, we simply have more atoms in this structure. They're both in the same physical state. A sample of just iron atoms has very little entropy associated with it. For our fourth example, comparing helium to neon, here we would look at our periodic table and identify which atom is larger. And so hopefully you have your periodic table handy, or you at least remember neon is further down and therefore it is a larger atom. Not much larger. If you compared values, there wouldn't be much of a difference, but we predict larger for neon. For our next example, we are looking at solid carbon. The difference here is we are changing temperatures. And so for this one, we predict carbon at a higher temperature to have a little bit more entropy. Again, the value between those wouldn't be very different, but a little bit higher for the higher temperature. Our last example, we're looking at 1 mole of oxygen in a 2-liter container versus 1 mole of oxygen in a 1-liter container. Now for this one, again, we think back to our definition of entropy. Remember that one of the ways that we can describe it is how dispersed or how spread out atoms or molecules are. So realize if I'm describing the same amount of substance, in other words, the same number of molecules, if they're in a 2-liter container, those molecules are going to be more spread out. There's going to be more space between them. They have more space to move around. So a little bit more chaotic, more dispersed, and more spread out. So a bigger volume for the same amount of gas would have more entropy.